How are our brothers and sisters coping with the current persecution? Let's take a look. And what you're going to see will break your heart, but also strengthen your faith.
At 6 a.m., my husband and I were woken up by a loud bang on the door. As soon as my husband had opened the door, people burst in shouting, "Everyone on the floor!" I saw them taking my husband into the kitchen and heard them very aggressively ordering him to do something. Then I heard some noise and I realized that he was being beaten.
My husband Felix and I were on our way back from the shopping mall to the car park. A Jeep with tinted windows blocked our path, and people with weapons jumped out, shouting, "On the ground, don't move." We were thrown against the vehicle. Felix was sent to a pre-trial detention facility where he spent a year.
From the very first bang on the door, I began praying to Jehovah for wisdom, calmness, and for Holy Spirit so that I could make the right decisions and act in the right way. And for the whole day, I was praying. Jehovah answered all my prayers, and I felt that he was close at my side.
Before each court hearing, when I was very afraid and felt overwhelmed by emotion and couldn't calm myself down, it was prayer that helped me to settle down.
When they took us for interrogation, I started panicking, and at that moment, I realized that I needed to meditate on something positive. So I thought, I need to sing our songs. And just one song came into my mind, "He Will Make You Strong." It really strengthened me. Those words about how Jehovah gave his son for us shows he loves us and will never leave us.
In September 2019, Felix was found guilty and sentenced to 3 years in a general regime colony. When he and the other brothers arrived there, they were beaten up by officers from the colony. Felix told me that he prayed while he was being beaten. And he noticed that at that moment, he stopped feeling the pain. "I have become stronger because, thanks to Jehovah, in a way I have developed almost a shell against the difficulties that used to scare me. That confidence and faith helped me. Jehovah was with me, and he will remain close by me. And we will be made stronger thanks to him. And we will get through these trials."
So we're well into the May 2021 JW Broadcasting episode, which is pushing this narrative of Jehovah's Witnesses being at the center of Bible prophecy. And a big way in which that's the case apparently involves the prophecy of the King of the North and King of the South. Russia is the King of the North. The Bible predicts that the King of the North will persecute God's people. And that's what's happening in Russia right now. Therefore, Jehovah's Witnesses are God's one true people. And their persecution has been prophesied in Daniel chapter 11. That's the whole point of what we've just been seeing. And let me be abundantly clear, I don't think I can stress this enough. In fact, I know I can't stress this enough based on previous run-ins with Christian Congregation of Jehovah's Witnesses. But let me be clear, I utterly condemn all of this. I don't want any Jehovah's Witnesses in Russia to be placed in pre-trial detention for ridiculous periods, to be subjected to incarceration and even beatings, essentially torture, just because of their beliefs, just because of what's going on in their heads. I am a believer in human rights, and we all have the right to freedom of belief. We have the right to believe a religion, and we have the right to walk away from a religion. And interestingly, Jehovah's Witnesses are in the business of denying that fundamental right when it comes to their cruel shunning policy and the way they weaponize the families of quote-unquote apostates to shun them, to shun those who leave as a means of exerting pressure, as essentially emotional blackmail, to make them rethink and come back in, or to threaten them against ever leaving. And it's because of this cruelty and this inhumane treatment, which incidentally Jehovah's Witnesses were recently punished for in Belgium. I recently did a mini documentary on it, if you check out this thumbnail. It's because of this issue that I take the position I can't have it both ways. I can't simultaneously complain about my human rights being violated as a quote-unquote apostate who is being shunned, whose family is being told to shun him, and at the same time look at what's going on in Russia and say, oh, that doesn't bother me. Well, they should know better. They deserve all of this. What do I care if Jehovah's Witnesses are being thrown in jail cells and held in pretrial detention and being beaten and being round up? What a heartless, what a hypocritical position it would be for me to take that view and for me to disregard so easily the human rights of people who were already suffering or who are already suffering due to being exploited and manipulated by a cult. These are people who deserve the help of the Russian regime rather than being rounded up in this way and rather than being subjected to this sort of brutish treatment. And what happens when totalitarian, authoritarian thugs like Putin go after religious minorities like this is it only emboldens those minorities, particularly in the case here. You have a group that's saying, we can use this. We can put this in our propaganda. We can use these stories of oppression, link them in with Bible prophecy, and suggest that the Bible predicted all of this. And we can use these stories to convince our followers that they have the truth, that they are part of God's one and only true organization. And that's not to take away in any way from the barbarity of what's happening in Russia. Again, I deeply, deeply sympathize. As I've said before on the channel, viewers, if I could stop it from happening, I would. And I mean that. If I were there when these thugs were doing these awful things and I had a means of stopping it, I would stop it. I just think it's wrong to treat people that way. It's not what I'm about. But make no mistake, all of this is being exploited and used and leveraged by the governing body, by the likes of Kenneth Cook and his associates, as a means of strengthening their control on the minds of millions of followers.